very sad day for Leeds. I think it's slightly sad for football.
This is an adventure, and I hope it can go a long way as an adventure.
We lived the dream. We enjoyed the dream.
I look on them all, every one of them in this club, as my own son.
Approaching the new millennium, a dynamic young Leeds team was mixing it with the best of English and European football, despite a number of off-field traumas.
Two young Leeds United and England footballers, Lee Bowyer and Jonathan Woodgate, were arrested today.
The crash has chilling similarities to the 1958 Munich air disaster.
The moment of the night up in Istanbul, football became the loser.
I just wanted to change the style, make us an attractive team.
It's a wonderful period in the history of Leeds United from a football point of view.
We've come a long way, but we're not. Leeds had failed to build on their 1992 League Championship win.
We've had success, we've had good times, but remember this.
Eric Cantona had become an instant phenomenon, but just months after he lifted the trophy, he was controversially sold to Manchester United.
It's a football club. Some things happen. And they're best kept in the club. All I can say is that it was not my decision to leave, it was his decision. And I was faced with a player who was sitting in France who said he was not going to come back and play at Leeds. So as I've already said, I didn't have a choice. And obviously those reasons I want to talk about, I've talked about, and those reasons I can't talk about, I won't.
It was a rumour that started about three different players' wives, and there's no truth in it whatsoever with any of the wives. And Eric wasn't that sort of person.
Did say something
with Eric. And I think what happened was that the fans had to have a reason why he left. And it wasn't just the fact that him and Howard had basically fallen out. They couldn't accept that. As I said, there's no truth about the rumours regarding myself or any of the players. Howard has to have people toe the line, and Eric wasn't a good person out the team. Great player when he's playing, but not when he's out the team. Dick wasn't really a great team man.
Fantastic! What a man he is! There can't be many better goal scorers than this fellow anywhere in the world.
Slip inside the eye of your man.
They briefly dazzled in Europe, but by the mid-90s, Leeds were caught in a downward spiral.
Leadership at Leeds had started fragment. The future of the club became uncertain because there were buyers out there in the market. Other people were mentioned as manager. The direction the club was moving in became uncertain, and that spread down through the club.
Nobody was settled, really. I mean, I was new at the club, and I was trying to establish myself. When things like that happen around the club, the club becomes destabilized, and every player don't know what's going to happen next.
Wilkinson's Leeds did have the chance of more silverware in the 1996 League Cup final, but they lost 3-0 to Aston Villa.
The League Cup final was really, it heralded the beginning of the end. And to be quite honest with you, I started not to enjoy driving into work.
And a 4-0 hammering by Manchester United early the next season brought the curtain down.
It is with great regret that I announce today that Leeds United have parted company with their manager, Howard Wilkinson.
It was time to go. I knew the manager they wanted. And it certainly came at the wrong time as far as the youngsters were concerned, because we were 18 months from having a new team. We were 18 months from Woodgate, Smith, Kewell, Hart, MacPhail, Bowyer. We were 18 months from them being ready to compete in the Premiership.
Any regrets at all after all these years?
Oh, look, you know, this is not the Parkinson show.
Wilkinson's replacement was the former Arsenal manager, George Graham.
I think he's one of the best managers I've ever had. Yes, we had a great relationship. I don't know if because of who we worked together, he likes to work with the defenders a lot. But, you know, as a disciplinarian, and straightforward and fair manager, I mean, that's what made me work hard. I think he brought the best out of me.
George never really played many young players. I mean, he played Harry Kewell, you know, and Harry was probably, I mean, he's outstanding in all the young players, and, you know, for the point of view, physical strength and pace. You know, George's reign at the club was reasonably successful, although people probably didn't enjoy watching him as much as so many teams that have played since then. George liked players to play. It's funny when you get people like George, who had, to me, he was a flair player, and when he became a manager, he concentrated me on the other side of the game.
When George came in, there was the need to make sure we weren't going to get beaten, and of course that's what happened in George's first season. We didn't score a lot of goals, but we didn't let a lot of goals in either. So he built from the back, and you know, George was a very experienced and very good manager, and I think George was the right man at the right time for Leeds United.
Shortly after his appointment, Graham brought in a one-time Arsenal lieutenant as his right-hand man, David O'Leary.
They were a team when George took over that were heading for relegation in many ways. The club needed sorting out discipline-wise off the pitch, and it really needed steadying, and it was a hard, hard job, and George did a fantastic job on that.
There's an angel. Contemplate my
faith. O'Leary was on board the team's charter flight, George Graham wasn't, on March the 30th, 1998, when time stood still for that Leeds United squad. Coming home from a midweek game at West Ham, the plane crash-landed at Stansted.
It was just a lucky night. You know, we could have taken off in our aircraft, and our family's all asleep in bed, and probably told that we'd been killed, but we got lucky.
Because we managed to get out alive, people dismiss it as if it wasn't particularly a serious incident. I think anybody who reads the direct report on it will see how serious it was, because if the pilot had done what he should have done, which was circle the airport to come back in again, the report said the plane would have exploded and we'd all be dead.
You just didn't know where you were going to end up, and luckily after all the screeches and the whatever, we were going to a halt, the plane was on fire, there was a smell of diesel or whatever, you know, petrol, whatever, fuel from the tank, and you thought maybe we're not going to get out and it's going to blow up, but we did get out, and it was fine, and, you know, the grace of God, we're still here.
I'm loving angels and quite welcome.